Oh, is there a new highlights video out? So they're looking for a sheriff.
Move along, please.
Who is Primm Slim?
Howdy, partner. Welcome to the Vicky and Vance Casino and Museum.
Reprogram him to serve as the sheriff. I don't know if I want to reprogram him. Fallout 3 is where it got refined. Fallout New Vegas was a pretty significant enhancement to the Fallout 3 engine from what I've seen so far, to the point where even though I am familiar with Fallout 3, New Vegas is still a bit overwhelming. Yeah, but it looks aged, but it's not bad. Wait a second, did you ask Monk where to find his channel? Oh, I see how it is. So when Monk wants you to watch his stream, you're cool with it. When I ask you to watch mine, you're like, nah, I got better things to do. Is that how this is? Is that how this is? Is this a yes or no question? Is that how this is? Uh-huh. Oh, Noob wants me to give you the link to his channel.
He's like, I'd probably
click on you. Tried to measure my charisma on a automatic vigor test.
Yeah, so the last time that Ari was up in Ohio visiting her friend, I was like, hey, why don't you check out my stream? She's like, eh, nah.
Unconfirmed reports say
Yeah. Go ahead. Pip out your channels. Evidently, Ari cares about everyone else's channel but mine. All right, so the Mohave was the delivery place, and that place is empty, if I recall. Monk, that loot is hilarious / insulting. Uh-huh. All right, so I think we're done in Primm. Let me check my quest real quick. My kind of town. I don't want to reprogram him to be the sheriff. See, we've got a prisoner and the NCR as well. And I haven't really taken a stance on the NCR, so I don't really know. ED the Gibson scrapyard. No, I don't want to do that. I want to reprogram her. Head to Novak through Nipton. Find them in Oak, so that's the main quest. What's the world map look like? Nipton, the Mohave Drive-In.
Yeah,
what? People want to see friggin'.
No, they want to see me and Evil and Fraggle slaying on PUBG.
But they don't get to see Fraggle when you're on PUBG.
Well, they get to see my personality.
No, they don't see that either, because you don't stream.
Well, I mean, they can hear, right? I'm sorry. We were playing musical chairs in game. It was hilarious. Aw, thanks, Block. Hi, from a noob.
Yeah, so we're having a difference of opinion here. Anyway.
Yeah.
Wow, I've got crap all over the place. Neutral. Ari does not stream, although it would be awesome. I find it interesting that these places list. So are these just neutral locations in general, or are they just neutral factions to me? I don't know. So I think we're done here in Primm. Let's go visit the NCR across the street and see what they have to say. Yeah, that's pretty much how it goes. Alright. But one thing's for sure. I do love me this laser pistol. Yeah, so the radio has kind of become a staple of the Fallout series, starting with Fallout 3. Like, there's a DJ that starts to comment on what you've done around town and stuff, whether good or bad. And they play some music and stuff, so it's not just like tumbleweeds the entire game, so it adds kind of like a chill momentum. But so, one of the things about Fallout is that it's always old music. So that's why, like, you hear, like, Dean Martin and all this older stuff, because it's just kind of become a staple of the series. So anyway, how you fellas doing tonight? Alright, Lieutenant Hayes, I think this is the guy I was talking to earlier.
Controlling the Mohave almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
Yeah, I bet it does.
Controlling the Mohave almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
Echo. Yeah, but I don't know. Like, our possibilities are either we can reprogram the robot to be Primm Sheriff, we can ask the NCR to do it, which, from what I've heard the NCR stands for, I'm good with. Although there's probably a friggin' double edge on that one. Or there's a prisoner that the NCR has that they could ask to be a sheriff too. And they seem to be leaning towards the NCR's prisoner. Oh no. So they say they need some law. That's what they've said.
We know Primm is a great strategic point, and we aren't blind to the needs of the town, but we're barely holding our own against the powder gangers.
And they've got a supply issue.
We don't
have
the guns or the personnel needed to carry out our mission, much less take on defending this town as well.
What do you need to take over? I would be here, but I'm spending time with your wife instead. Excuse me a moment. I have something I need to take care of. Let's keep the hands to ourselves, you two.
But what up, Kelly? Evil's butt is so delicious and scrumptious.
Noob, I think you were onto something earlier. So, let me just say that I object in whole to that loots that you just gave me. Decent, kids. I got work to do. Good luck.
Thanks.
Yeah, so they've admittedly got a supply issue, and I feel kind of, like I said, when I play these games with morality systems, I always play a good guy. Like, I just can't do it. Like, Mass Effect and stuff, I can't go Renegade, any of that mess. Like, although I've seen some of the Renegade options, not of this game, but, like, Mass Effect and stuff, and some of them are hilarious, I just have trouble, like, isolating the morality of it from myself. So I can't, like, I can't do it, and I may like the from what I've seen of the NCR so far, but they've admitted they've got a supply issue. Why would I ask them to protect Primm? So I'll keep on looking. Nice things and then get bored. That's fine. See, I just like helping people. It's who I am, and I can't divorce how I play games from that. I've not played Skyrim. There's something about, like, first-person medieval weaponry fighting that I just have a lot of trouble getting behind. Particularly the sword fighting, because it's just so slow. Like, you run up and you're just like, oh my gosh, man. I know a lot of people love Skyrim, and maybe one day I'll get around to it. Maybe. But for now, yeah. It's just something that's on my mind, Noob. I'm kidding. I would never do that. The other side of what sign? Which one? Rita's Cafe? This one here? Or did I miss one? Okay. Open all night. Our pies are out of this world. I bet they were. Who are you? You're showing us hostile. Holster your weapon. That's kind of messed up. Oh, fun enemies.
He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around.
I'm a little afraid to approach this building now. Oh, he's a convict. Fixer, temper. I don't really take a lot of the medication, so in the Fallout universe, if you take a bunch of medication of a certain type, you can become addicted to them, and then they have bad effects to you if you don't keep taking it. And generally, you have to go to a doctor to have the addictions removed or whatever. Evidently, this will do it for you. Yeah, I take stem packs. Stem packs are... Whoa. Yes, I know how to fast travel. Thank you. Well, hello to you too. Let's go say hi. Uh-oh. Okay. You guys have got a fair amount of health. I hope I didn't just make a mistake. Let's go for it. Oh, wow. Stop ducking around. You're making this harder on yourself and me. You're wasting my ammo. Come. Oh my gosh. Potato aim engaged. Man, that took way more shots than what was that? All right, let's see what they got. I'm not big on the unarmed combat, and I still need to sell stuff. I missed an opportunity. Nevada Highway Patrol Station. I'm gonna leave and sell some stuff and come. Oh crap, I can't. Crap. I can't fast travel while there are enemies nearby. Oh good, it does show that my faction there. Yeah, I mean, I suppose I could do that. But I'm going to switch to something I've got more ammo for. What do I have now? DPS 22, damage 5. So I'm looking for something that's not an explosive, because I'll kill myself with it. I'm certainly not going to kill them with binoculars. Yeah, the 9mm pistol. I got 140, like 150 rounds of that. Yeah, let's keep doing that. Desk, nothing. Yeah, I need to loot later. I've already forgotten. Those sound like... I bet. See, like... I really don't like that sound. Ooh. What? I'm not gonna like opening this door. I hate bugs. Yeah. These things have such small bodies. There we go. Mutated insects. I hate that sound. Ooh, a reloading bench. I definitely want to see that. Oh, come on. Dead prospector. Alright, so I'm curious. They seem to have added a mini game in this called Caravan that it won't let me play until I have a certain amount of cards. Yeah. Yeah. And I haven't quite come to grips with what all that is yet. What did I miss? There's one. Hey, buddy. Yeah, bullet time me shooting a mantis. All right. Let's see what we can do. Made at skill requirement ingredients. Oh. Okay, break down. What is recipes? What is breakdown? Pistol powder, primer, lead. So, like, if I do this, I'm actually going to take bullets that I have and break them down to base components. Break down scrap metal to lead. It definitely looks like I need to do that. Why? Oh, okay. 400 leads. Okay. Wow, you'd think that would be very... Hail Hydra! I'll go ahead and pick that up. That's usually worth a lot. Alright, so now I still gotta kill this dude. Alright. Stop that. Yeah, and it kind of gives it a chill atmosphere, in my opinion. Like, for some people, I'm sure it gets tiresome after a while, but that's why the DJ is part of it too, because it makes it sound like a real radio station. And it's better than just having, like, just a game where you walk around where you hear 3-Dog! Yeah. So the person that Kinder is referencing is the DJ in Fallout 3, and he's a really cool person. I like his personality. But what's really funny about 3-Dog is that there's opportunity in the game for you to meet up with 3-Dog. He's a character in the main story quest. And if you kill 3-Dog, which you can do, someone else replaces him on the radio. But she's completely like depressed, and she's not good at it at all. And all she does is rail on you about killing 3-Dog, and she doesn't know who did it. He's like, some bastard killed 3-Dog, and she'll like get off the radio crying or something. It's hilarious.
Got it.
All right, good. You got some caps. I'm wondering if this NCR money is going to come into play later. I'm going to hold on to that, especially since it doesn't weigh anything. Yeah, so the Fallout games take place all in the same universe, but in different locations. I don't know where Fallout 1 and 2 took place. I'm sure Kinder knows. Fallout 3 takes place in what is called the Capital Wasteland, which is the ruins of Washington, D.C. and the immediate surrounding area. New Vegas takes place at Vegas, obviously. And Fallout 4 takes place at the Commonwealth, which is Boston and the area around that. And it's an interesting story about like the civilizations that came up and grew around Atomic Cocktail. Energy resistance and fire resistance. If they're anything like these fire ants in Fallout 3, I'm holding on to that. Don't need the beer. Blood venom. Ooh, that weighs a lot. I need to find a place to stash that. I'm just selling some stuff to free up some weight and get some money. This is going to be something you see me do very, very frequently. See, that's the thing. Like, if you can... you're on Windows 10, correct, Locke? So I can help you with this if you want. There are some compatibility issues with Fallout 3 and New Vegas in Windows 10. The engine did not grow well with that. But I can help you with that. I mean, I'm running this on Windows 10. I'm running Fallout 3 on Windows 10. It just takes a little work. It's not great out of the box. But curious about this canyon wreckage. I think we're going to go take... No, I'm going to loot this first and then head up to the canyon wreckage. Fallout 4... See, I'll be completely honest. I had played Fallout 3 several times, never finished it. Like, I would get up to a certain point and then just bail. Like... and I couldn't specifically tell you why that is. Just, I couldn't stick with it. Fallout 4 was the first Fallout game I ever completed all the way through. Yeah. I don't know if I want a shotgun or not. Do you already have this shotgun? Hang on. Single shotgun. I wonder if I can... Oh, sturdy caravan shotgun. It's already in good condition, so I don't need this. In Fallout, you can repair a weapon with parts from another weapon you have. Oh, Joker 2, I'll take the card. I don't do melee weapons. Yeah, Fallout 4 was a really good game. Although, and it's very good at introducing, like, what's going on, who's who. Like, every game they treat you as if you don't really know what's going on. Although, in my opinion, New Vegas would be a rough entry point. Like, it was a rough entry point for me, even having experience with Fallout 4 and 3. Like, they've made so many changes. Fallout 4 is not bad to start with, to be honest. They're each individualized stories that don't rely on the others. They just kind of complement the universe. And I kind of have this thing about post-apocalyptic stories. Like, I enjoy seeing, like, when people explore it. Can I shoot that thing? Hang on. Sweet! Bye-bye, Crow. Like, whenever people post, like, I went through Chernobyl and took pictures, like, I'm fascinated to see that, you know? So the setting of the Fallout series really appeals to me. And I've kind of got this thing for exploring to a certain extent, and which I'm sure a lot of you saw when I was doing Breath of the Wild. Sunset Drive-In. Well, it sure ain't a drive-in anymore. Let's see, what can we get here? There seems to be nothing here. Bottle caps, yay. And of course, paper American government currency has no meaning here because there's no such thing as the US government anymore. So their currency in the Fallout universe is bottle caps. Bottle caps from bottles of Nuka-Cola. And since Nuka-Cola is no longer making bottles, it has a limited amount of currency, so it has value as a currency at all. Got some coyotes up here. At least I'm headed the right way. Hang on one second. Oh, he's talking about it. Impromptu militia. This according to an old man armed to the teeth with dynamite. In addition, troubling news from Primm as merchants report a large presence of armed unsavory figures patrolling the town. Residents are nowhere to be found. That's the news. This is Mr. New Vegas filling in for Mr. New Vegas. See? There it is. Like, he's already talking about crap that we've done. Although, in Fallout 3, if you do decide to start at LOX, the only radio station that you'll pick up at first... Uh-oh. Maybe I shouldn't have shot at them. They don't look too friendly. The only radio station you'll pick up at first is Enclave Radio, which is actually voiced by Malcolm McDowell, which is cool. Sometimes I listen to that because I think he's got a real smooth voice. Galaxy News Radio, the one that you want to listen to, is you can only hear in the DC ruins at first. Although you'll get a quest to expand its range. Aww. I know they're coyotes, but I still feel a little guilty shooting them. Oh, you're the alpha, huh? Alpha this. Yeah. It is a mite uncomfortable. But they're coyotes, man. They're wild animals. Aww. Yeah, I kind of don't like doing that. But their meat is good for something. Oh good, I'm almost there. What am I supposed to be doing here? What's my quest? The reunion. Travel to the canyon wreckage near Primm and enter the divide. Lonesome Road. Courier 6. Oh crap, I'm Courier 6. You can go home, Courier. Interesting. A canyon filled with... Lonesome Road is intended for experienced couriers. You cannot take and gear. You can carry whatever journey. Yeah, I'm not walking the Lonesome Road because I'm like level 5, not level 25. Walk away. No, thank you. What? Oh crap, I'm almost overburdened again.
The likelihood of you dying violently within the next 5 minutes is 87.61%.
If I went in, sure. All right, you know what? I'm going to save and then take a look inside and see what we got. Let's walk the Lonesome Road. Looks inviting. This almost looks like Silithus. What's up here? The silo. I have a sneaking suspicion I'm not staying here. What's this? Duffel bag. Bottle caps, MREs. Oh, cool. Missiles? Alright. I'm gonna get killed by the first thing I see here. I know it. What is this? This looks like a devastated city. What could this be? Oh, this is the silo. Hopeville Silo Bunker. Authorized Hopeville Ballistic Defense Station. Alright. You can go home, Courier. This is kind of making me feel a little claustrophobic. I don't even suffer from claustrophobia. A reactor. Silo blast door. And a switch. That doesn't... The console controls access to the silo, but it's encrypted beyond your ability to hack. You'll need to find something that can break the encryption in order to proceed. Alright. Maintenance access, level 3. Status. It's locked. Security measures inactive. I have a feeling when I open this, it's going to turn them on or something. I kind of want to see what's in the reactor first. It needs electricity before opening. Alright. I kind of anticipated running into an enemy before now. Get to fix the silo first. Nuka-Cola Quartz, that's new. Yeah, so Nuka-Cola is kind of hilarious. It's obviously the Fallout equivalent to Coca-Cola, but like, in the Fallout universe, everything was nuclear powered, everything. They didn't work on integrated circuits and miniaturization like we did in our universe. They took nuclear power and managed to integrate it into everything. And Nuka-Cola has some kind of radioactive isotope in it, which they test on people until they get, whenever they're working on a new product, they test it on people until it has killed the least amount of people in each test group, and then they release it to market. It has very much kind of a black humor sort of feel to it. Pod status, it's unlocked. Automated commissary system is shut down. Counterfeit proof paychets are exactly the same size and shape as ordinary bottle caps. Okay. I hope I didn't make a mistake letting that thing out. Whoa. Major improvement. Oh, this is Edie! Yeah. Yeah, what? It was during your... It wasn't your boot up sequence. It was recording something about someone called Ralphie. Oh, you don't want to talk, huh? Science, 35. Oh, so I can actually hit this one. Probably some old data floating around your memory. Nothing to worry about. Okay. Listen, robot. I own you now. I'm not going with that one. That's not... Enhanced sensors.
Experiment log 369248/B. iBot DuraFrame Universal Interface Override System. This is Dr. Whitley presiding. We've boosted signal gain and enlarged the overflow buffer system. That should ensure 100% connectivity and control. Eddie?
What?
Whenever you're ready. Yes, success. Reporting full success on 369248/B. Eddie was able to interface with and override the test panel in under 3 seconds.
So what, they were working on some kind of hacking robot?
Now let's start on the proposal for the full rollout.
That's a recording from your development. Can you override electronic security? Expository beeping. Only panels with a dish-shaped receiver. You know, this is giving me an R2-D2 sort of feeling. All right. Aw. All right, let's keep moving. I should have asked about his creator. But at least he can access that console. Arc welder. This is going to overburden me, but I want to see what this does. Bonus damage versus robots and power armor. Oh, I can't use it until I don't want to attack Eddie. Aww. All right. I don't want to get too invested into this because I know we're not going to get to go through it all the way. I'm bailing. I don't want to get too invested in something I know I'm not going to be able to do. But this is Edie. So, at least I found that. Happy Trails. I think these are all DLC, so I shouldn't have really clicked on that anyway. Find the men who kind of... I actually am kind of thinking of reprogramming the robot at this point. Because it's a stance I can take that doesn't have me either pissing off or joining the NCR when I have no idea who they are. So I'm going to go see Shunned. I am shunned at the NCR Correctional Facility. Why?
Yeah, I know.
Why?
Wow.
All right. I'm going to see if I can go reprogram that robot. See what that does. So, how are you guys enjoying the playthrough? I know I'm kind of wandering through it aimlessly, but that's kind of the appeal of Fallout, is that you can't really do anything wrong. It's your playthrough. You do it with it as you want.
Howdy, partner. Welcome to the Vicky and Vance Casino and Museum.
All right. You gonna be sheriff now, boy.
Law enforcement protocol is reinstated, partner. Initializing use of force authorization. Authorization found. Yeah!
My kind of town. You know, that's a little confusing when you say yeehaw to being made sheriff.
This is the Vicky and Vance Casino and Museum, Primm's premier tourist attraction and resort destination. Yeehaw!
That is creepy. Who were Vicky and Vance?
Where have you been, partner? Hiding under a rock? Vicky and Vance were this nation's fourth or maybe fifth most infamous celebrity outlaw couple ever. That's who they was.
So they're like Bonnie and Clyde?
If you can spare a minute to hear the tale.
Sure, tell me the story.
Yahoo! I ain't had a chance to tell that tale in a mess of years.
I kinda like
first
this robot.
First, any boss you've heard about Vicky and Vance being copycats ain't nothing but ill-tempered slander. Fact is, they begun their crime spree 2 days before Bonnie and Clyde robbed their first bank. So who was copying who?
Who's
now,
a little
true,
oversensitive
Vicky
here?
Vicky and Vance didn't exactly cut a wide swath of murder and bank robbery across the central U.S. like Bonnie and Clyde did. It was more like a narrow swath of shop. Check cash and fraud and gas pump drive-offs. But crime is crime. They drove reckless, too. Having lived by the gun, well, Vance owned one anyway, it was only fitting that the duo of desperados would die by the gun. Perhaps it was fate itself that accidentally drove them into a crossfire between police and a gang of bank robbers in Plano, Texas. Or maybe they just didn't notice until it was too late. It's been said that Vicky would have tried to cash a bad check in that bank had she lived. We'll never know for sure. All we know is that the crossfire tore the car and both occupants to pieces.
An official apology.
You can put your eyes on the genuine death car just over yonder. And there's Vance's machine gun in the case next to it.
Okay. That was... Tell me about Primm.
Primm is a thriving resort community located in Clark County, Nevada, right along Interstate 15. Whether you can't wait till Vegas to try your luck, or want to hit one last jackpot before you leave Nevada, Primm's your place. The town's premier attraction is the world famous...
Yeah. Enough of the marketing. Ah, crap. Goodbye. That's what I was aiming for. Ooh, right. I leveled. I already forgot. I'm going to keep boosting science and lockpick, because I like being able to get in stuff. Oh, Ari's telling Evil to get people, which means she's already dead. Science, lockpick, and speech, and people may agree with me on this. I disagree. Obviously, this is an RPG. People play it however they want. But in my opinion, lockpick, science, and speech will unlock things that you can't get any other way through a weapon. So that's why I tend to really focus on those first. I will occasionally put points into other skills, but I will hit those 3 to 100 before I really seriously start working on any other skill. Educated, 2 more skill points every time you advance in level. That I want. These I've already seen. Yeah, I definitely want more skill points every time I level. That's a big one. Alright. I love this concept of, like, some of the clothing that was found in the trunk. There's nothing there. And the machine gun is gone. Cool. The actual weapon Vance carried in a paperback rat box under some suitcases in the trunk during the... Never fired! I love this whole, like, they are so friggin' jealous of Bonnie and Clyde, even though they were, like, fifth-rate criminals. That is hilarious to me.
Well, if it isn't the Lawbringer.
Dang straight. What's your problem?
My problem is that I'm no longer a deputy. I'm just a beagle now.
That's not what your name says.
Right. I don't wish him no harm, but the law to him is a set of...
Adios, Locke. Thank you for
not
stopping by.
Not everything is black and white. I'm not sure a robot can ever understand that.
Like some of the men do. All right. So we've helped Primm, and that dealt with that. So I think... Oh, you know what I ought to do is see if I can sell something in here and free up some of my carrying capacity. See if I can find a vendor in here somewhere.
Hold
on, please.
Welcome.
What's up, Ruby?
Back. Good.
Bless you.
Welcome back.
Wait.
Good.
Are you a vendor? Ah, crap. She's just offering to make some of that venom casserole for me if I've got some rad scorpion venom, which I don't. I love how everything here is about gambling. Obviously, it's New Vegas, so I wasn't really expecting anything else, but... Safe can't open. Where is everybody? Why is this room empty? There are so many people here. Because it's night. Alright, so I'm going to wait until morning. See if we can get some more people in here. Because I need to be able to sell stuff. And if the establishments are closed, I can't sell anything there, can I? Alright. Find it curious the bank is never open. And I can't do anything in red. Like, if it's listed in red, I can't do it without taking a reputation hit. And since I'm playing a good guy build, I can't really do that. If I do it, I will only do it ever by accident. Where the crap is everybody?
Howdy.
Are they in the casino now? Since I cleared it out of bad guys, is that where they are now? Nobody's here. The muse of what?
It's like the muse of what? You said I bring the best out of him.
The fact that Monk has a best of anything is confusing to me. I am not jealous.
Howdy.
Why? There's no vendors here at all? Oh, I can go to the friggin' general store at Good Springs. I can sell some stuff there. Uh-oh. Ah! Excuse me. I got a what? To the town of alright. General store.
Howdy. That was a hell of a fight.
Nice. Show me what you got for sale. Ooh, you got a lot of caps. Alright. I'm not selling the currency because I feel like I'm going to need that. Do I even need the binoculars? They don't weigh much. I wish I could sort by weight. Cat eye. Nope. I do want to sell the coyote stuff. Wow, that's heavy. That crap is really heavy. No wonder I was out of weight. So is this stuff. I don't want to get rid of it. Empty syringe. Don't need it. Frag mines. These are heavy and I don't use the explosives. Gecko hide. Bye bye. Wow, animal stuff used to weigh a pound in Fallout 3, and now they're really heavy. So that's something I need to adjust to. Oh, I have a flamethrower. I didn't even know that. Cool. Lead. I like how lead doesn't weigh anything. Lightweight leather armor. Metal armor. Excuse me. Don't want the dynamite. Maze. Nah, don't need the corn or the lunchbox. Sell that. Don't need the Nuka-Colas. Don't need the cigarettes. Pilot light. Goodbye. Pre-war money. Goodbye. All of this trash I can pick up that's worth stuff that I for caps. So I'm really good at generating currency. Scrap electronics. Ooh, those are heavy. Single shotgun. Don't need the squirrel stuff. Ooh, these are heavy too. I'm keeping them because these are exceedingly rare. And when you need them, there's nothing else that provides this buff. This massive, like, it's literally like the predator cloaking field that goes around you. So I need to find a place I can put these long term so I'm not carrying them, but for now I have to carry them. Don't need me none of them sarsaparilla. Don't need a switchblade. I'm gonna have to experiment with these throwing spears. I don't think I'm gonna need them, but I'm gonna hold on to them for now. No whiskey, no wonder glue. Alright.
Another satisfied customer.
Actually, I'd like to see what you've got. I'll take that card. I mean, after all, I would eventually like to be able to play a game of whatever it's called. Crap, I should have looked at what he had before I friggin' sold him all my stuff. Now it's all, like, diluted. Except.
Another satisfied.
Alright. Big I am going to take a quick peek at the cemetery just to see what's there, because it's on my map and I'd like to at least just get it out of the way. See what's up there. Man. It's really pretty though. Fallout 4 is particularly interesting too. Like, I love this. If, for those of you who don't, who care about this, don't, you know, you can plug up your ears or whatever. But in Fallout 4, when you get out of the vault, okay, you can, is this where I was killed? You can, when you get out of the vault and you tune to the radio, the kid who runs the radio station has like serious anxiety issues, and he's like one of those people who like is constantly kicking himself for making mistakes. It's hilarious. And one of the quests that you get later in the game is trying to find a way to boost his confidence. And if you pull it off, he actually sounds like a good DJ from then on out. All right. So I am shunned by those people. Let's get back to the patrol station. We'll keep working our way down. I ran someone over, a one-on-one shootout, and shot someone out of a moving vehicle. Ari brings the best out of me. Glad to hear that, Monk. Where's my map again? I want to make sure I'm going the right direction. Nipton! What in the world is with those statues? Mohave Outpost. Neutral. That's literally what they're just talking about. A scorpion. Be our partners in crime. A bark scorpion. Alright. It's about that special someone you find only once in a blue moon. Alright. Another gas station. Whoops. Nipton Road rest stop. Let's see what we got here. Besides a crate that I'm kicking around callously. Oh, it's got the moonshine symbol on it. That's hilarious. What is... Oh, crap. Oh, frick. Rad scorpions. I hate these things. Oh my gosh. I think this is what Kinder was warning me about. Scorpions, like they are so dangerous sometimes that just like they immediately like red alert. Poison gland, give me a poison gland out of you, and that way I can get some of that might kill you stew from that what's her face at Primm. Anything here? Nothing in here. Can't go in. That is a full who nut. Alright. That dude says Lester on top of it. You like it, do you? It's growing on me. You know, I've played Fallout 4 and I'm about halfway through a play of Fallout 3. But I'd never played this before, so that's why I wanted to play it on stream. And at first it was really overwhelming, but it's really starting to grow on me. Get some ammo. Gun cabinet. Oh, I can't open that yet. Crap. Salisbury steak. All right. I hope no one lives here who's going to be pissed that I'm looting their stuff. But I think if that was the case, I would have a warning about it. Flour. Clearly, this was a general store. Ooh, Mayor Stain's journal. Guess whose luck keeps rolling? All right, show me the notes. Hang on. Misk. I hardly believe my luck. Challenges. Oh, right. I did buy all the DLC for this. Mr. Fox, when we were alone in my office, he let it be known he's a member of the Caesar's Legion. Often spend time in Nipton. It turns out that the Legion hates and wishes to make an example of both groups. Interesting. I didn't think a moment before accepting it. All I have to do is convince the Powders to kidnap the NCR troops at night. Yikes. 8,000 caps. Back to the NCR. Stockpiling some supplies in a safe house between here and the Mohave Outpost. Whoops. Hang on. Signed with a steady hand on the keyboard. Super Mayor! Someone's real big on titles. Alright. Safe house between here and the Mohave Outpost. Let me see where that is on the map. That's the Mohave. Well, it's... I was headed to the outpost anyway. I'll run into the place. Excellent. And I might just run into whoever that is. Am I headed the right direction? Alright. And we're off. I might check in here real quick, though, too. Empty inside. Like, depressed or sad that it's over? Because, I mean, I can understand the sad that it's over thing. Depressed is like, this is going to bring me down, huh? I will say, like I said, it was really overwhelming at first. Because, like, I've played Fallout 3, I've played Fallout 4. And, like, they've added so many mechanics, like ammo types, rebuilding ammo and stuff. That's just kind of like, whoa, 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 whoa. This is a lot. The factions thing. Oh, it's a little baby one. Bye bye, little rad scorpion. Little murder machine. But, like, it was really overwhelming at first, and I'll admit, I don't fully understand it. Like, the damage thresholds and all this stuff, and there's so much to it. But the story of it, like, who is Courier 6? What's the deal with the platinum chip and all that? Like, it's starting to grow on me quite a bit. Where's the safe house he referenced? Because this is the outpost. Where's the safe house? He said it was between the gas station and the outpost. Is there anything over here? Yeah. So, I've already done the Good Springs Powder Gangers thing, and I've already done... I wound up reprogramming...
Hello there. It's good to see a friendly face. I almost took you for a raider, I did. Name's Malcolm. Malcolm Holmes.
So, Malcolm, what you doing out here?
Don't suppose you'd care to trade. I'm missing a few essentials and... Oh, screw this. Lying just ain't in my nature. I'll tell it to you straight. I've been following you for a good bit now.
Creeper, no creeping? Why?
It started off innocently enough. I was traveling, as I often do.
Blue star caps.
And I happened to observe you picking up one of those blue star caps. You didn't show any reaction to it, so I figured you didn't know what you'd gotten your hands on.
What?
There's an old wasteland legend that says somewhere out there is a fabulous treasure from before the war. Those caps with the blue star on them, the tale goes, are the key to that treasure. They're called Sunset Sarsaparilla Stars.
All right. Where can I find more?
All over the place. The easiest place to find them is unopened bottles of Sunset Sarsaparilla. You'd think they'd all have been picked clean by now, but somehow, new bottles keep appearing in the machine.
It's the alcohol fairy.
Some say it's old Festus that does it, hoping someone will finally collect enough caps to earn the treasure. Other than bottles, you'll just have to scavenge. You can find caps in the unlikeliest of places, and Blue Star caps are no exception.
Why am I hearing explosions? Festus, who is that?
It's said that the treasure is guarded by a man named Festus, and
Dinner
he's the
bell.
One who asked for the Blue Star caps. It's also said he's been around since the war, standing a lonely vigil, waiting for someone to come and take the treasure off his hands. That'll make him pretty damn old, but I've met a few people in my travels who claim they actually met him, and they weren't the lying type either.
Okay, so you collect them?
Nah, I gave it up years ago.
Then why were you following me?
And even if I did still collect them, I'd tell you the same. There's people out there so mad with the idea of treasure that they'll attack strangers just on the suspicion that they have some of those caps.
If I get close and I miss it, I would appreciate if you spoke up and mentioned that I left something behind. Otherwise, I would appreciate if you kind of kept spoilers to yourself. I'm trying to kind of do this as a fresh, clean playthrough from a player who doesn't know anything about the game. Although I do have the tendency to miss what is obviously sitting in front of my face. So if that happens, please let me know. But if it comes to like advanced knowledge or hidden treasures or something like that, just kind of keep it on the down low if you would. I'd really appreciate that.
No one knows. Money, weapons, water. It is, or maybe was, something of value. And that's enough to get people motivated. When you say no problem. If you do end up trying to collect more stars, watch out for a man named Alan Marks.
Oh, great.
He's killed several people for their stars already.
This feels like some kind of weird marketing ploy. And given where I am, I'm almost inclined to think that's exactly what it is. Like, there is no treasure. There's just, like, a robot that's just, like... It's like the proofs of purchase on cereal boxes or something. All right. Frick. NCR citizens, quote, the devil in disguise. Nope. Don't want nothing to do with rad scorpions at my level. For a mass, quote, return to sender. Move it on. Thank you for the host, Invis. Appreciate that. Prisoner control following a successful
Whatever. Baldy, pass me a sensor beam.
What, do you think I'm just giving these away?
Stinky sock, tutti frutti. Ooh, tutti frutti. That's a good bean. You know, I should have turned around to check and make sure those scorpions weren't following me before now. Hang on a second. Stockpiling some supplies in a safe house between here and the Mohave Outpost. I read that here. Here is the Mohave Outpost. There's not... The only thing I see that's in between is these turned over... There's gotta be something here. The one thing that I have read about New Vegas is that people rarely give it to you straight in this game. So it leads me to kind of like doubt everything I hear. Stash. Take that. I'm trying to keep it to stuff that's very useful or very low weight. Wow. Traffic just came to a standstill when the bomb fell, huh? I'm a trusting kind of person. But when I hear like the logic conundrum, I am lying, everyone around you is lying, like, it's kind of like, okay, cool. So I need to take everything with a grain of salt. I already did. It comes in, I changed it to green to match Fallout 3 because that's what I'm used to. I left the HUD the same though, because I think it kind of matches the environment. All right, let's go see the Mohave Outpost. What, is this made out of metal? New Ranger. Oh, this is an NCR place.
Oh, gosh, there's somebody there.
Something tells me Ari just died. NCR Ranger Outpost Mojave. All right. Or maybe Mojave? All right. Prepare to... Dude, don't friggin' crawl under fences. What the crap was that?
Crazy to brave those roads.
What's this place?
Outpost. Mojave Outpost. Watching a lot of nothing feels like a big Brahmin pen for caravans. They've been stopped for a while, waiting for the roads north to clear, or their clearance papers to go through. Looks like you've walked away, so if you need to shake the dust off, head to the barracks.
Oh, good, I can sell stuff there.
Not much, but better than nothing.
Any work here?
Nothing I know of. But if you've come from the north, means you can travel freer than most around here. Might check the barracks. Someone might need you to hoof it somewhere. Just be careful you go
what
up
happened?
On the roof. Got a sniper watching the road. If your gear's in need of repair, HQ's also worth checking out. Talk to Major Knight, he can help. Provided you got a pen and plenty of ink.
Excuse me. What are those statues? Yeah.
Those two? Represents unification.
I say we take off and
mostly
do
good for shape. Won't do much else when the Legion reaches us.
Wow. You're friggin' Captain Positivity, aren't you? All right, Caravaner.
Primm has a new sheriff. That should keep the powder gangers away.
Yes, I know. I programmed him to be the new sheriff. Thanks for the news. Sorry, I need to clear my throat. NCR trooper. Nope. You don't have a name either. Let's go inside the headquarters and see what we got to see. The Legion awaits at the gates of hell, and NCR is going to send him in. Ooh, I like these propaganda folders. I like the styling of that. That's very cool. Major Knight.
Caravan, citizen, pilgrim, or...
Citizen.
Just need something for the logbook. Keeping tabs on traffic throughout the outpost. Although mostly just in, not out these days.
So a lot of refugees,
if you're looking
huh?
For the commanding officer, he's in the back. Although, he's got a lot on his plate, so if you speak with him, keep it short. Also, if you need any gear checked, we can get you up and running again. Once you fill out the work orders and sign for the parts, of course.
Hey. I'm a little reluctant to throw him with the NCR. I don't know much about them right now, but at least I can...
Help? Oh, well, you could speak to Ranger Jackson. He might have something for you. He sort of runs things around here. Mostly ends up sending reports back west that aren't filled with the best news.
Who are you?
Me? I'm Knight. Major Knight. I've been stuck here dealing with these caravans for ages now, but somebody's got to do it.
Yeah, this is a dirty job for you?
It ain't so bad. If Caesar's Legion decides to push west through Nipton, old Mojave Outpost here will be the front line.
Alright, I'll see if he can repair anything. The pistol. Wow. He can full repair stuff. Wow. Okay. I definitely want him to repair my pistol. Because that's been what I've used most of the time. I think I'll keep it to that for now. I don't have the money for him to repair everything. Tell me about the outpost.
Border guard duty mostly. It's our job to make sure the caravans can move safely along I-15 and Highway 95. Not the best posting or assignment, but it beats being sent east or patrolling the Colorado. Legion's pretty thick there.
All right. So, oh, no. Don't want to get in trouble accidentally stealing your stuff. No. Get off my back. Oh, I can't even get a drink. All right, look around. Nothing. The restroom. Can't do anything here. Gotta be careful. I don't want to get in trouble here. Ooh, Ranger Jackson, aren't you the commander?
Looks like we got a new visitor in the old Brahmin pen.
What are you fighting that guy?
Many people coming
here. You got
that
under control? You know, because
passing through.
There's a lot of stuff on fire.
And if you're passing through, you picked a bad time. Road north has gone to hell. If I let a caravan through, they won't make it.
Those don't look like sunglasses. Those look like pirate patches. Are you blind?
Hey, buddy, how are you doing today? I hope you're having some fun outside. It's been pretty much crazy.
Yeah, and his mustache goes like all the way down his neck. Yeah, he kind of does. Except that Dr. Disrespect wears sunglasses, and although these are supposed to look like sunglasses, I think, you notice the texture is opaque. Like, I literally think they're pirate patches. You've got enough soldiers.
Soldiers, no. Recruits, yes. And the Mohave Outpost has been ordered to have a standing force at the NCR perimeter at all times. So sending anyone out reduces the outpost's numbers and would be in direct violation of my orders from back west.
Oh, it's the NCR, so obviously it's being run from California. Are they sending more troops?
Sending more troops, yes. To reinforce the outpost, no. Troops head through here on their way to McCarran, or to the front lines at Forlorn Hope. Or they're on leave, on their way to New Vegas to piss away their pay. All of them, passing through.
Alright. Yeah, you do sound frustrated.
Frustrated? No, I have my orders. Signed and approved all the way up the chain from Kimball. And I understand the reasons. The outpost isn't a Legion target, yet. Not like Vegas or the Dam. But if the caravans get choked here, that's gonna bite NCR hard. Anyway, didn't mean to talk your ear off. Some days, just feel like more requisition forms and daily reports come across my desk than results.
Okay, how can I help?
Help? Now look, I appreciate... you know what? Yes, I could use the help.
You know, I really don't like that sudden turnaround.
We need to get the caravans moving again. That means clearing a path north.
Oh, I gotta kill rat scorpions.
The road to allow it.
Sounds like a deal.
Thanks, I appreciate it. Come back here when you're done. I might accidentally lose some supplies to pay you.
Oh, cool. Demonstrating dishonesty to a new hire. That's a great first foot to start on. Can you find it in your heart? Really, that's the name of the quest. Clear out quick critters. Oh man. Crap. I was hoping to avoid killing more rad scorpions because I hate them. I don't like fighting rad scorpions. They give me the heebie-jeebies. I don't like bugs. What the crap, man? What are those things filled with helium? Scared the crap out of me. Let's have us some sarsaparilla. Give me some of them blue star caps. All right, sarsaparilla, sunset sarsaparilla. Oh wow, this is actually, is, no, I don't want to drink. I can't pick up this deck of cards. I clearly want a deck of cards and no. Like, everything can be picked up except these cards. Of course.
Hello.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Out of my face, fellas. All right,
new
Lacey.
Face in the outpost. Must have come from the north. So, what do you have?
I feel like I recognize her voice. Is there any work?
Work around here? Might check with Jackson in the main building. Or ghost up on the roof above, but watch out. She's kind of a bitch. Don't tell her I said that, though. Might take a bullet some night when I'm going to the latrine.
Hi, Miss Fraggle.
Hi!
How are you?
Oh my goodness! My allergies have been horrible!
Allergies? You don't have any sinuses. How can you have allergies?
That is so rude. Am I not a human person to you?
Sure you are.
Of course I am!
Okay. Thank you, Miss Fraggle.
I have a joke for you. What does a bee use to brush its hair?
What does a bee? Hold on, wait. What does a bee use to brush its hair?
Honeycomb.
Oh gosh.
One more in honor of the pollen season.
Thank you.
Where does a bee go to use the restroom?
Where does...
Words are hard, yo!
No, wait, I'm thinking.
Where does a bee go use the restroom?
Okay, where does a bee go to use the restroom?
Give up?
Yes.
The BP station!
Oh, man, I knew that one.
Hi, Evil!
You know, you're kind of in my face right now.
Oh! I just want to see what you're doing.
Playing a game.
I'm not a bee joke.
Thank you for stopping by. Hey, I appreciate your jokes.
Yes, we do have the same hair color.
What?
Exactly the same hair color. We are both gingers to the core. In fact, his third game picture is literally carrot hair. Imagine this with my color hair. Really cute. Wait, what? I guess you're looking at Miss Fraggle. What? What do you say? Are you going to be evil to keep Miss Fraggle when Eric goes to live with evil? I'm confused.
What about?
I'm confused. Why are we going to live with someone else?
It looks like she's not developing a thing for you, Evil. Miss Fraggle stays with me.
Well, I keep hearing about his butt, but I've never seen it. Maybe I should be tagging along with PUBG. And then I'll make my decision.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Well, have fun.
Bye, Miss Fraggle. Thank you for stopping by. By Miss Fraggle.
Not too much. A lot of caravans going nowhere. A lot of troopers going nowhere, too. A few prospectors here and there, but they don't do more than stink up the place. Everybody's
right.
Backed up here. You'd think it'd be good for business, but most of the traders are tight with the caps, even the larger caravan outfits.
How'd your games go tonight, by the way? Hoping to pass the time with a game or two. I can't play
caravan. All right. I'll give it a go.
Aren't you gonna tell me I can't? Yeah, okay. So, oh look, it's Cass! That is hilarious. Hi Cass, you look different than in your streams.
Looking for trouble?
No, I'm just
we'll
keeping
keep
it myself.
And turning. Or I'll set him spinning.
Cass
got
is
no time
aggressive.
For doctors, or anyone looking for something I ain't selling.
Are you all right?
All right? No, I'm not all right.
Awfully
drinking
forward,
to
aren't
forget,
you?
And it's only getting me mad instead. Whiskey always gets my temper up now more than ever. Drinking used to cause all sorts of trouble back west. Before I punched enough people, that is. And they learn to lay low when the whiskey hit.
Yep, does sound like Cass. What are you trying to forget?
Lost my caravan heading north. The driver burned to ash. And they didn't even take the cargo. They just burned that too.
Wow, they got a thing about you. Why would they do that?
My guess is Legion. They're trying to cut NCR supply line. And the Mohave Outpost is proof.
But why would they not steal the supplies?
New Vegas virgin. No caravans in. Out and just try arguing with Jackson about it. Roads aren't safe, he says. No shit, you washed out old fuck up. I didn't need a brotherhood scribe to tell me that.
Dang. I've met him nice in person.
Yeah, he's been with NCR so long, all he can see is the worst outcome of everything. So he doesn't do anything. Jackson won't let me head north. It's not safe. And even though my caravan's gone, my caravan papers are keeping me here. So if you came here for work, my advice? Go find the Crimson Caravan branch south of Vegas. They can help you out.
Okay. What can you tell? Heartache by the number. Wow. Cass gave me a quest.
You're looking at it. It's a watering hole without much to brag about. It's like a Brahmin drive gone wrong. Supposed to be a gate north, but you come here, you get caught in the pen.
See ya.
Better to head back home. If you don't have a gun and a will, Don't matter much what you do when you reach here, except stare at that fucking monument outside. Don't even tell me you missed it coming in. It's like NCR showing its dick to all the East.
Wow.
If the Republic put as much effort into protecting the East as they put into those two asinine giants outside, then they'd be worth that monument.
You know, I...
Statues of two men shaking hands covered in blood. Don't seem to be nothing to brag about.
You know, I feel like you're really pulling your punches here. Why don't you say how you really feel?
I'm speaking figurative. Isn't any blood on their damn hands. Of course, when Caesar comes walking through here, there'll be blood for real. And after the blood dries in the sun, he'll melt that piece of jet-induced sculpture down and reshape it into a bull.
Wow, by my you're kind of a mean drunk.
Deficiency of his. But no matter what the state of his pecker, he's sure giving the West a good fuck.
Good lord! Okay, I think I'm done talking to Cass. Wow. NCR Trooper, NCR Trooper. Alright. Anyone else here? Caravaner? Hi. Or Caravaneer? Alright. Said there was someone on the roof. I'm gonna go talk to whoever that is. There's Sniper. Ranger Ghost.
You a courier?
Are you an albino?
This might be your lucky day. If you don't mind walking a bit. And your eyes are good.
You know, I'm kind of thinking they call her Ranger Ghost because she's an albino. But if she's an albino, doesn't that mean she shouldn't be out in the sun? Depends on the work.
I think there's trouble in Nipton. No traffic from there on the roads. And while I can explain that away, the smoke from the town I can't. I'm sure
something's on fire.
What I need to know is mystery solved. It might be powder gangers with all that smoke in the air. If there's anybody left, they'd be in the Nipton Town Hall. Go there. Check it out. Let me know what you find.
Why don't you check it out? Yeah.
Got my post. Don't think I wouldn't go, too. If troubles hit Nipton, town's got enough camping spots to rack up some easy kills. Not about to have Jackson bust my ass again, though. Even if I came back with Caesar's head, rather be sitting here than in a cell.
Yeah, man, I guess I'll check it out.
All right. Look at you. All fired up and ready to go. Wish the others around here had that kind of attitude. Listen, I don't want you getting killed for this. So if you head there and run into trouble, I'm asking for eyes and ears, not your life. All right?
Don't get me wrong. I don't develop games. But the way that that woman's cheeks, like, go up through her sunglasses sometimes as she talks, like, it's unnerving to me. Like, every time I see it happen, I'm just like, ugh. Any news from the West?
Kimball's Kimball. Not sure which end is his ass or his head.
Who's Kimball?
Caravan families are causing trouble. Big circle getting tense. The usual. Look, you want gossip? Go to the bar downstairs and listen to a whole lot of nothing.
No, me? I've met Cass.
I gotta keep watch, then fill out the daily log.
Okay. The outpost.
Not much to tell. One of the worst posts in the NCR if you're looking to be anything more than a babysitter. Full up here, but just enough so we can't send out patrols. Gotta maintain a standing force. Jackson's orders. NCR's orders. Can't spare men for patrols or escorts, so caravans are backing up here like a Brahmin with a bottle in its ass. Typical NCR bullshit.
Just waiting for a person like me
Mind
to
yourself on the plane
pull the cork
down.
Out. Alright. So let's see, we got some stuff to clear up here. And we freed up. How am I already full up on weight again? Alright. Jeez, I thought I had just sold stuff. I thought I had just sold stuff. I need some kind of permanent storage somewhere where I can stuff these kinds of things. Not you. It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. Where was the person who I was talking to earlier? Not you. It was an actual vendor.
Back again, I see.
Yeah, you don't sell anything. It was a vendor who had a crap ton of cats. So I could sell him pretty much everything. And now I'm full up on stuff again, and I... Oh, that drives me crazy. and I need to free some of that up before I hit the road again. Back is it you? No, not work. What do you have for trade? Okay, you've got a crap ton of caps. Binoculars. Yeah, I need to sell this dynamite. I'm not going to use it. Incinerator. See, like, there are some weapons I don't really use, but I want to keep. And in Fallout 3, I have player housing that's mine. Like, I had the deed to it. It's my place that I can go in and just dump things at and go back to later if I want them. And that's a great place for me to leave something big and heavy like this incinerator. It weighs 12 pounds. But I don't have anything like that yet in this game, so I kind of want to carry it. But man, it's really eating into my weight. Varmint rifle. I'm wondering if I shouldn't be using this instead for a little bit. Let's see. Apparel. And anti-venom. The anti... this bleak venom I would put in here, I have no idea why I would use this. HP minus 15. It literally just hurts me. Why would I use this? But it might come in handy somewhere, so that's why I'm holding on to it. But this Salisbury steak goes away. Squirrel on a stick. Scotch. Turbo. Blah, 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 blah. Buff out. That's looking for things that weigh something. Alright, aid. So, misc. That's where. Yep, don't need this. Drain. Duct tape, don't need it. Leather belt, pre-war money. I'm gonna hold on to these because I can get food out of these. An exaggeration. I'll be fine. Ammo doesn't weigh anything unless you're in hardcore mode. And I'm not playing in hardcore because I'm not crazy. So. That should. And I want to dump some of these. Alright, so I should have 48 pounds of spare carrying capacity. Woohoo!
Whatever. Baldy, pass me a sensor bean.
What do you think I'm just
I
want to
say butter popcorn or caramel. Moldy cheese or caramel corn? Caramel corn. No. Yes. It's caramel corn. Alright. Nothing in here. So. They want me to clear the road. So that people can friggin' start running caravans again and stop getting stuck in that outpost. You okay, hon? Not looking forward to the raid tomorrow. Tomorrow would have been a good day for some PUBG streaming, to be honest. I used to. And I love the guildies, but I don't enjoy the activity anymore, that's for sure. Little raid cells. like in my blood, it's like little cells that are like, don't stand and stuff! Attack the ads, not the boss! I'm saving. Those look like giant ants or spiders. I'm already not on board with whatever the crap those are. There's spiders or oh my gosh. It's an ant. Oh my gosh. Get away from me. Die. These things are uber creepy. I hate bugs. I hate it. Die. And kill anything, Lord. What? Holy crap, you're huge! Jeez. These giant ants, man. I do like that they give you aim down sights in this game. It's something that's desperately missing from Fallout 3. Like, I find in Fallout 3 that I'm killing everything using bats because I can't guarantee accuracy. Yeah. With aim down sights, I don't need bats near as much, and I find that helps the combat flow work a little bit better. Is that all of them? Are there more ants around here? Statement. Yes, indeed. Oh wow, that was literal. That was it. I did the quest. That's it. Nipton Town Hall. Where is that? Okay, so there's Nipton. Go work for the Crimson Caravan. Where are they? Holy crap! They're up there. This is like up at the Strip. Yeah, so I'm not going to be dealing with that for a while. But at least we cleared the caravan route, so we can go back and report on that.
This is Mr. New Vegas fanning the flames of your passion.
Alright.
NCR Correctional Facility is now under prisoner control following a successful riot.
A successful riot. That's an interesting way to put it. So let's go to Jackson, tell him we've cleared the caravan route a little bit. Friggin' giant ants. Homie, don't play that.
Back again, I see. Something you need?
Okay, you evidently weren't the one who gave... Oh, Jackson gave me the quest. Where's Mr. Sunglasses Indoors? Where is he at? He asleep?
Hello?
Ah, there you are. Dr. Disrespect, how you doing tonight?
Wish I had more work for you. Nothing else on the radar at the moment.
Cool. You mentioned a reward?
No, I mentioned you might accidentally get supplied. And I meant it. Not allowed to contract mercenaries at the outpost. Still, a requisition form or two can get lost, and they're not gonna come check. So here you go.
Okay, cool. If you shaft me, I'm gonna put some lead in your head. All I'm saying. Items. Ammo. Why is this all grayed out? Oh. So this is the 5.56, and I have some 5.56 that's armor piercing. Interesting. Okay. So you equip a weapon, and then you select the ammo you want to use for it. I was curious how that worked. Alright. So let's
doing
see.
Doing a lot of good work out there, setting an example for the others. I know Ranger Jackson appreciates
you. You wouldn't think so by the way you joked around about shafting me earlier.
I'm nice. Major nice.
I know who you are. Shut up. Wait, I need to ask you if you want help.
I suppose you could...
Yeah, blah, blah, what kind of trouble, blah, 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 blah. And I take it Jackson has nothing else more to say?
Appreciate the help.
Okay. So I think I'm done here for a little bit, and I'm going to head to Nipton and see if I can save the town from whatever the crap is on fire over there. yeah, whatever, shut up. Just give me the Cliff's Notes. That's all I need. For Ranger Ghost. Alright.
We won't go.
If I've already listened, like, I'm listening to the entire conversation as a courtesy, so that people who are listening but not watching can still follow along. But if I've already listened to, that's kinda neat. If I've already listened to the conversation once, I'm not listening to it again. You get it the one time. If I've heard them say that crap before, yeah, whatever. Skip. What? Important information? Whatever. And this is what I enjoy about Fallout. It's just kind of chill, going around, helping people. I don't like the shooting ginormous gross insects aspect of it, because those things creep me out, man. I hate them, the giant ants in particular, and the rad scorpions. I hate them. But like, oh, and we haven't even run into a death claw yet. Those things. Yeah, but at least with people, there's no time to be like, ugh, gross. It's like, oh my gosh, I'm dying. Kill him, kill him, kill him. I got 2 kills with a mini earlier today. I felt almost dirty doing that. Check the map. Yeah, I'm headed the right way. But like, this is kind of something that I enjoyed about the Breath of the Wild, and I think the Breath of the Wild did it better, but it's a newer game, so I can't fault Fallout. Is this exploration aspect of it. It's just like, you know, you've got a... Thought I heard something. You've got quests and waypoints to go to, but as you go to them, you can look around and be like, ooh, what's that? What's over here? Like this right here. We've got a plane sticking out of the ground. I'm gonna go take a look and see if there's anything cool over here. And maybe there's not. Maybe there's some kind of death monster that's gonna kill me. I don't know. But you don't know till you look. And look, I got some ammo for my curiosity. Yeah, I'll be honest. That game I was playing with InvisiPie earlier, where I shot someone out of the back of a... I shot out a passenger out of the back of a buggy moving perpendicularly to us with a car. That felt really good. Oh, more scorpion. Ah! I hate bugs, man. Shut up. I hate these freaking bugs. Oh, use the Billy and the...
What the heck was...
I'm
really that scary?
I wasn't expecting you to just show up.
Well, I mean, of course I showed up. You're screaming like a girl. Yeah, I wonder. Do you need to go change your undies?
No, I'm...
Whatever. Baldy, pass me a sensor bean.
Why you think I'm just giving these away?
You lose. Barrier toothpaste.
Because I'm not.
Ooh, berry. Good bean.
Berry!
No, I don't need... No. Service rifle. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Wait, he's bailing? He's just like, screw this, I'm out. I hate these freaking rad scorpions.
I have a gift for you. You complain all the time about being a ginger like me. Well, I have a lesson for you. It can always be worse. And people, whatever I put on his head, he has to wear it until you say otherwise.
They're never going to say otherwise. It will last until the end of the stream at maximum.
Well, that's it then. That means you don't love them. Alright, here we go! You wanna see what it is, people? It's something brand new, never done before! Here we go! Take off your headset!
Oh, gosh.
In honor of Dr. Seuss Week! Who actually, upon research, he wasn't really that great of a person. But that's besides the point. I crown you with Ding Wang Ding Two Hair.
To clarify, I am quite able to destroy this army, but you will not permit it. And then there suddenly appeared before me the only one my arms will hold.
I heard somebody whisper, please adore me. What do you think, people?
You know, wearing wigs is more of an Invis's thing.
I think it looks beautiful on you.
Beautiful?
Get it? Gotta wear it. Or do you want me to look for a different hat? What do you think, people?
Thank you.
Get a beam!
No.
Yes!
No.
Beam, beam. So they can ask you for a beam without me?
Alright, fine. Grass or lime?
I want spoiled milk.
It's grass. Thank you, Miss Fraggle. Have a good night.
And now that I know everybody, they're gonna hold you accountable.
Yeah, whatever. They can hold me
Okay.
But remember what time it is.
Well, it's 12 minutes of misery. At least it's better than 1 minute of misery. Alright. Bye.
Good night, Miss Fraggle.
Bye.
Great kid. Don't get cocky.
Ah, yes. Oh, he's bailing. Oh, he's limping away. Whatever. You don't shoot at me and then get away with it. I need to check his crate. See if he's got some 5.56 for me. 357 Magnum. Cowboy repeater. Nah. I'm not in the... What the? Oh, hey, buddy. I don't know, if I was you, I'd have screamed before I died, but alright. Beer, we got some 10 mil cases, purified water is always good. Yeah, exactly, like he waited until he just like wham, 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 like, oh man, shoulder's a little stiff, finally dies. Ah! What the frick is going on? To the town of Oh, hey! You are not friendly! Good to know! Crit! I thought you guys were like witnessing a crime or something. I wanted to help you out, but no! You had to go and attack me. Oh, you're all bad guys. Oh, frick. Ow! A shot in the head for each of you. What the? These two in front of you and that dude over there. Oh, cool. I didn't kill any of them. Oh, you've got armor on. You don't. I am shooting you in an unarmored region. You die. Nah, she's got armor on, which...
I've got you now.
What the? Who are you? You've got a name. No, that's not how this works. No, you don't get to cry for help. You shot at me, now you die. That's how this goes. Oh, now you're turning shooting at me again. Oh, this is where I was. Well, at least, yeah, I didn't notice that.
Mohave almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
Yeah. At least I don't have to clear the road of ants again. That's the good news. All right. So while we make our way over to whatever the crap that was all over again. So, I know that there's armor piercing and hollow point rounds, but considering I just got some armor piercing rounds, which leads me to believe, like, this is armor-piercing 5.56 as opposed to normal 5.56, which makes me wonder, are there three classes of ammo where there's normal and then hollow point and armor-piercing? Or is it just there's armor-piercing and then the unlisted one is hollow point? Because anytime I shot that dude wearing the shoulder pads, that little shield symbol showed up next to her thing, which says she's wearing armor and my shots aren't doing as much to her. Yeah, bang, 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 ow. Yeah, so it may be that I haven't actually run into hollow point armor yet. This is one of the many questions in the game that I have in regards to the enhancements that they've added with New Vegas. Like, they told me about all these different armor types, and they've alluded to the fact that there's, like, lower quality ammo that is cheaper, but wears your gun out quicker. I haven't seen that yet. I don't know how those things are denoted, and it kind of freaked me out in terms of, like, okay, so now there's, like, 8 different types of classifications of ammo, and you're not telling me how to know which is which. So I'm definitely going to save before I hit, what was that, over here? Well, I mean, it's important to remember, Monk, this is also a game. They're not looking to perfectly represent real life here. Okay. I don't have boom. I should probably get it. Oh, that scared the crap out of me. I don't like being snuck up on by horrendous insect monsters. They creep me out. I hate them. Oh, look, more ants.
Whatever.
Baldy, pass me a sensor beam.
We're just giving these away? Because I'm not.
Holy crap, there's more ants over there. I don't like bugs. Caramel corn, moldy cheese. Like, when I screamed at that last amp, ant, Ari literally spoke up from the living room and said, "What is your problem?" Thanks for the sympathy. Moldy cheese. Giving startling accounts of the legate known as Lanius, who is said to be Caesar's top field commander. One refugee told us the legate took over an underperforming squad of troops by beating commander to death. The legate, in order to. Oh crap, I'm out of ammo. Okay. Weapons. And you thought your boss was. Hey, cool man, have you seen my new clicking handle? These binoculars actually kind of suck. You want to see how much these binoculars zoom in? I'll show you. Fire! That's it. It's like, what? Maybe a 2? Ah! I hate these friggin' bugs. How am I not hitting you? I'm done. Die. I ate the bean. It was caramel corn or moldy cheese. It was moldy cheese. Yay, I leveled up. Good grief, I hate these bugs. 4 in here, 4 in here, 4 in here. And then we'll put Survival. Hit points from food and drink. Oh, gosh. And forward and repair. Hate these bugs. I know I sound like that friggin' like PTSD like ranger or whatever it was from Wreck-It Ralph, but I don't like bugs. Big boy pants. Right. Is that what I've been missing all this time? Screwing with you folks. Grenades. Your husband should play. Oh, you think you're so funny, don't you, noob? Look, I'll admit, I'm a complete and total wussbag when it comes to these friggin' ants. But, like, I have nothing to say. Honey! They're making fun of me! Absinthe? All right. I'm wearing my blue hair, chill. Like, her response to they're making fun of me is, you better be wearing your blue hair. If you're gonna suffer, you might as well suffer in style. Oh gosh. Alright, I know I've killed more people than that here. Mac and cheese, whatever. You know what, I'll do the mac and cheese. No, I won't. But hey, I took out that group of Jackal Gang members for reasons. For frag mines. Woohoo! Let's pick a lock. That was sure worth it. All that work, risking death, dying, dealing with ants, getting scared. What the frick is going on now? No, it just means you reload from the last save. What is going on over here? Oh crap. She's a friendly.
Help. You there. Please help me.
I would love to. What? You're both friends. Oh, this is Thomas.
Please help me.
Come on.
Oh, you don't like me now, do you? Uh-oh. I did a bad. Did you notice when I killed him, it said I lost karma on top? I think I was not supposed to kill that kid. But they're both friendly. How am I what am I supposed to do with that? But I don't know who to help. I mean, clearly something's... Hey.
Did you see that? That crazy bitch just attacked me out of nowhere.
Hey, kid, I totally didn't kill. Any idea why?
No, none at all. We've been traveling together since I picked her up a few days ago. And she's been friendly this whole time. We'd actually been flirting a little when she suddenly pulled a gun out and began yelling at me to hand my caps over. Now that I think of it, though, she laughed when I threw her my money. I think what she really wanted was my Lucky Charm necklace.
Always after me Lucky Charms! So, I don't know how to tell you this, kid, but I think that person who you thought was your companion was actually an escort looking for payment? Yeah, tell me about your Lucky Charms, kid.
Yeah, every once in a while you can find a cap with a blue star on it.
What?
They're pretty rare, so I started collecting them.
Yeah.
Once I had enough, I made a necklace out of them, since I thought they were lucky.
Oh, I'm so close to being able to talk him out of those caps. I'm gonna try it anyway. It's gonna fail.
Even if what you're saying is true, I think I'll take my chances. This necklace and I have been through a lot, and we're both still kicking. If that's not lucky, what is?
Lucky f- Oh, I can just be more careful in the future. I'm not gonna coerce him.
I will. That's the last time I pick up a straggler on the road, believe me.
Alright. So, I think we're actually going to call it a night there. So, this has been an interesting stream where the predominant activity has been Gilly is scared by bugs over and over again. So, those of you who know me may not know this about me, and the fact that I am easily startled. I am very easily startled.